Hi everyone and welcome to the very first episode of Empower Best Practice Series. In this new livestream series, we would like to give you some tips and tricks for using our products Empower Slides, Empower Charts and Empower Docs, but also from time to time for using Microsoft PowerPoint and Microsoft Word in general. So for today's first livestream, we have chosen the topic Getting Started with Empower Slides. And in the next couple of minutes, I will show you how you can choose a master in Empower. I will give you an overview of the Empower ribbon and the Empower quick access bar. I will show you how you can insert content to your presentation. And finally, how you can search within the Empower library. If you have any questions, please feel free to send us an email at empower@madeinoffice.com, and we will put all your questions and the answers to our help center at support.madeinoffice.com. Okay, so let's get started. So the first thing I want you to know is that Empower is completely integrated in PowerPoint. The advantage for you is that you still have all the PowerPoint functions plus the benefit of the Empower functions. So you find all the Empower functions such as the Agenda Wizard, the Design Check, the Empower Library, or the Layout Toolbar, and many, many more integrated in the Empower ribbon, which has been added to PowerPoint. In addition, you find the Quick Access sidebar on the right side of the window. With that sidebar, you have a quick access to the Empower library, such as the company library and your personal user library, but as well to the templates. These are slide templates, text elements, charts, tables, icons, and images, but also videos and even smart arts. The last one is the master section where the master of your company is saved. All templates you find here are in the corporate design of your company and for you ready to use. If you want to create a new presentation, just click on New in the Empower ribbon. If you always work with one master, you can choose a default template by selecting a master and then click on default template. If not, just select the master you would like to create your presentation with and then click on create new presentation. So the new presentation is opened now and the master we have chosen is in the background. And we can now start creating our presentation. In the beginning, we are inserting an agenda with the Empower Agenda Wizard you find over here. You can choose a layout for your agenda here and type in the title of your agenda. And then just type in the item title. So let's assume that we are creating a presentation about our company and our products. So the first item would be about Madeinoffice. And the second one, maybe our clients. And the third one, our products. You can rearrange the items by drag and drop or by using these buttons, move up and move down. You can also make items to sub-items. For example, if you would like the second one as a sub-item, just click on this button and now it's a sub-item. Here on the right side, you find some more basic settings for your agenda. You could, for example, insert an overview slide on the beginning of the presentation. You can insert agenda slides for every sub-item. And you could insert different elements for the content slides, for example, chapter reference, navigation, or slide numbers. By clicking on Create Agenda, the agenda will be inserted in your presentation. As you can see here, for every item and every sub-item, an agenda slide has been added to your presentation. And in this agenda layout we have chosen, we can add pictures to the background of the slides. So we are choosing an image from the template library, for example, this one for the first slide. And for the second one, maybe that one. And let's take this one for the last, just by double clicking on the picture. And now we can start adding content to the presentation. So for example, by inserting slide templates from the company library. So for the first topic about Made in Office, we could insert a facts and figures slide. So I navigate to the company library and just browse for the slide I would like to insert and just double click on it. And maybe for our clients, let's insert another slide, this one. So you may decide after you have finished your presentation that you want to change the order of the agenda. That's also very easy with the Empower Agenda Wizard. Just click on Agenda again, recreate it, and then just update the agenda. So for example, our products should be the first topic. And then I click on Update Agenda. And as you can see, the agenda slides were updated and rearranged accordingly, but also the content slides. So that means you don't need to worry about rearranging your whole presentation after you have uploaded the agenda. Before we are saving the presentation, let's run the design check. Empower is checking your presentation if it complies with the corporate design of your company. So for demonstration, I'm inserting a text and I'm using a wrong font, maybe this one, and now I run the design check. You see the design check shows me now that I have a font error and I can now autocorrect this error using the autocorrect function, and the presentation now complies with the corporate design. This of course also works for font sizes and colors. We are planning to do another live stream with the topic designs, so please make sure that you subscribe to our newsletter to be informed about that. Okay, now that we have finished the presentation, we can save it to the Empower library. And to do so, just click on Save in Library. You are being asked now if you want to save the presentation or just the single slide. I have selected. I could even save a single element or more than one slide at once, for example, a slide deck, or because I have the permission now, I could also save the master. But for a presentation, I choose to save it as a presentation. And here in the Empower library, you can now decide where you want to save the presentation. In the company library, that's the first part, they have all of your colleagues access to. Or in the second part, that's your personal user library, there only you have access to, but you can collaborate with your colleagues using the permissions. So I'm choosing this folder here and then just click on OK. And the presentation was saved successfully. So I'm entering again the library by using the library button, and you can see the presentation is saved here. In the library, you can search for all elements. It doesn't matter if they are saved in the company library or in your personal user library. Just type in the search word here in the search bar, and the results will be displayed. So let's search for content related to our other product, Empower Docs. And Empower is now searching for the search word I have inserted in the element names, but also for tags or for the content of the slides. You can add tags for every slide by using this tag button over here and just enter any tag you wish. Now you can filter the search result. So for example, if you only want to see presentations, just set the filter for presentations. And now only presentations with the keyword we are searching for are shown. Okay, that's all for this first brief overview of Empower Slides. You find more information to all our products and to Empower Slides at our support center at support.madeinoffice.com. You can search here for any topic you find interesting. So for example, if you require more information on the last topic we have discussed, the search, just type in search here. And you find all the information available in our knowledge base. For example, this Help Center article about search and filter. All right, thank you for watching this episode of Empower Best Practice Series. Again, if you have any questions regarding the topics of today's live stream, please just send us an email to empower@madeinoffice.com. Goodbye and have a nice day.